हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ टुडे लेट्स कंटिन्यू अबाउट दी पाइथागोरियन ट्रिपलेट. सो टुडे लेट्स सी डेफिनेशन फर्स्ट. डेफिनेशन ऑफ अपोजिट पैरिटी. द डेफिनेशन सेज एन इंटीजर्स and integers x and y are said to be the same parity if either both even or both odd. If either both even or both odd, they are known as then of same parity. Now another thing, an integers x and y are said to be of the opposite parity if one is even and other is odd. One is even and other is odd. For example, 3, 5, 3, 7, 4, 6, then 4, 8 are of the same parity as they are either both even or both odd. Fine. Now another one, let r equal to 3 and s equal to 2. Here 2 and 3 are of opposite parity. Okay, with r of opposite parity with r greater than s greater than 0 and GCD of r and s is what? The GCD of 3 and 2 is what? 1. Okay, therefore what is x? X is r square minus s square, that is 9 minus 4 equal to how much? 5. Y is equal to 2RS, that is 12. And Z equal to R square plus S square, that is 9 plus 4, it will be 13. Therefore, 5, 12, 13 is a primitive primitive Pythagorean triplet. Similarly, let another one, suppose let r equal to 5 and s equal to 4, then again these are of opposite parity. Then find x as r square minus s square, that is equal to 25 minus 16, that will be how much? 9. What about y? Y is 2rs, that will be how much? 40. Z is what? R square plus s square, that will be 25 plus 16, it will be how much? 41. Therefore, the integers 9, 40, 41, this also is also a primitive, is also a primitive Pythagorean triplet. Primitive Pythagorean triplet. Now let's see one example here. Show that if x and y are of the same parity, then their addition and subtraction are of same parity, So what we have to do here, x and y are of same parity, then we have to prove their addition and subtraction are also of same parity. So let's see the solution of this. Suppose x and y are of the same parity, that is either both even or both odd. If x and y both even, then x is equal to 2k1 and y is also what? 2k2, where k1, k2 are what? Are in Z. These are in Z. Therefore, what is x plus y? X plus y is 2 times k1 plus k2, which is even, and x minus y is 2 times k1 minus k2 is also even, means are of same parity again. Now if x and y both odd, then x is of the form 2k1 plus 1 and y is of the form 2k2 plus 1, where again k1, k2, what? These are what? Integers. Okay. Therefore, what is x plus y? X plus y is 2 times k1 plus k2 plus 1. K1 plus k2 plus 1, which is even. And x minus y is what? 2 times k1 minus k2. This is also even. So when we take both are even, then also we get addition subtraction even. When we take both odd, then also addition subtraction even, means of same parity. Hence x plus y and x minus y are of same parity. parity. Okay, now let's prove one theorem which is related with this part. We are assuming x is x square minus x square, y is 2rs, z is this, and it forms a primitive Pythagorean triplet. One theorem regarding that part. So let's see the theorem. The positive primitive solution of x square plus y square equal to z square with y even is x is equal to r square minus s square, y is equal to 2rs, and z equal to r square plus s square, where r and s are arbitrary integers of opposite parity. Arbitrary integers of opposite parity with r greater than s greater than 0 and GCD of r and s is what? 1. Now proof of this. Let's see the proof. Suppose x, y, z is a primitive Pythagorean triplet. Okay. Since y is even, so x and z both must be what? Odd. Both must be odd. Okay. Now, odd integers. Now, if this is y is even, x, z both odd, so this gives x plus z and z minus x both even integers. Okay, this gives us x plus z is equal to 2k1 and z minus x is what? 2k2, where k1, k2 are what? In z. Therefore, x is equal to k1 minus k2 and z is equal to what? k1 plus k2. You can simplify that part. Subtracting them, we get x, and adding them, we get z. As y square is equal to z square minus x square. Why does this? Because it is a Pythagorean triplet. So this will hold. This is same as z minus x into z plus x. So z minus x means what? 2k2. Z plus x is same as x plus z is 2k1. So this is 4k1 k2. Y square is 4k1 k2. This gives k1 k2 is equal to what? Y by 2 square. Where y by 2 belongs to what? Z. As y is even. Y is even, so y by 2 means in z. Fine. Now also note that GCD of k1 k2 is 1, because let's we prove this. Because if GCD of k1 k2 is d, which is some bigger number than 1, so this gives d divides k1 and d divides k2. That implies d divides k1 plus k2 and d divides k1 minus k2. So d divides k1 plus k2 means d divides z. This gives d divides z and d divides what? X also. So this gives GCD of x and z is what? D, which is greater than 1. But this is a contradiction to the fact that x, y, z is a primitive Pythagorean triplet. If it is primitive Pythagorean triplet, then the GCD of these doublets x, y, y, z, x, z is what? 1. We have seen that lemma in previous video. Okay, so that will be what? A contradiction. So which is a contradiction, which is a contradiction to xyz is a primitive Pythagorean triplet. Therefore, GCD of k1, k2 is what? 1. GCD of k1, k2 is 1. Now, as k1 into k2 is equal to y by 2 square, and GCD of k1, k2 is what? 1. Okay, this gives both k1 and k2, this product will be a square of any integer and their GCD is 1. So both are what? Perfect square. This is also one lemma we have seen. Both are perfect squares. That is k1 is equal to suppose r square and k2 is suppose s square. Okay, where this r and s are in set of positive integer. Okay, thus we get x is equal to r square minus s square, r square minus s square. Fine. Z is equal to what? Put up the values here, k1, k2. Z is equal to what? R square plus s square. And y is equal to what? 2 times r and s. 2 times r and s. Plus minus 2rs. Y square is equal to 4 k1, k2. So y will be plus minus 2rs. But as x, y, z are positive, x, y, z are positive, so r is greater than s and s is also greater than what? 0. So they are also what? Positive. Therefore x is equal to r square minus s square, y is equal to 2rs, and z is equal to what? R square plus s square. the square. Okay, so now to show that GCD of R and S is 1. Suppose GCD of R and S is D, which is greater than 1. So this gives D divides R and D divides what? S also. That implies D divides R square and D divides what? S square also. That is, D divides K1 and D divides what? K2. This gives GCD of K1, K2 is what? It is greater equal D, which is greater than 1. It contradicts that GCD of K1, K2 is what? 1, which is a contradiction to GCD of K1, K2 is what? 1. Therefore, GCD of R and S is what? 1. Now, to show that what R and S are of opposite property, that thing we have to show. R of opposite parity. So suppose R and S are of same parity. Let's assume they are of same parity. If this is, then this says either R and S both even or both odd. So that is same as either R square and S square both even or both odd. Either they are even or odd. That is, R square plus S square and R square minus S square both even. R square plus S square and R square minus S square both even. But what is R square plus S square? R square plus S square is nothing but X. And R square minus S square is nothing but what? Z. So what does this say? This says X and Z are both even. But what we have seen here? Y is even. So X and Z both must be what? Odd integers. So this part contradicts to this part, that X and Z both odd. So let me write that part here. That is, this implies, this is X. This implies X and Z both even, which is a contradiction to both X and Z are odd. So this case, R and S are of opposite parity. R and S are of opposite parity. Thus, if X, Y, Z is a primitive Pythagorean triplet then X is equal to R square minus S square, Y is equal to 2RS and Z equal to R square plus S square, where R and S are arbitrary integers where R and S are arbitrary integers of opposite parity and GCD of R and S is 1 and R greater than S greater than what? 0. Conversely, suppose there exist an integers and integers. Conversely, suppose there exist an integers R and S satisfying given condition such that X is equal to R square minus S square, Y is equal to 2RS and Z equal to R square plus S square. What is the claim? The claim is that X, Y, Z is a primitive Pythagorean triplet. So to show it is a primitive Pythagorean triplet, we need to show first it is a Pythagorean triplet and the GCD of all these three is 1. These two parts we have to do here. So for that, let's consider X square plus Y square. Put up these values what are given to us. Consider X square plus Y square, that will be R square minus S square whole square plus 2RS whole square, that will be R raised to 4 plus simplification is what, 2R square S square plus S raised to 4, that is R square plus S square bracket square, that is equal to what, Z square. Therefore X square plus Y square equal to Z square, that is X, Y, Z is a Pythagorean triplet. Now to show that X, Y, Z is primitive Pythagorean triplet. Suppose GCD of X, Y, Z is D, which is greater than what? 1. So if GCD will be D, then D divides X, D divides Y, and D divides what? Z also. That is, D divides X plus Z and D divides Z minus X also, using the properties of divisibility. Okay, that is same as D divides 2R square and D divides 2S square. Let P be any prime such that P divides D. Okay, this gives P divides D, D divides this, so P divides 2R square and P divides 2S square. So this gives P divides R square and P divides S square, since P is not equal to what? 2. That is, P divides R and P divides S by property of prime number. Okay, now this gives us GCD of R and S is greater equal P, which is a contradiction. Contradiction to GCD of R and S is what? 1. So this says GCD of what? X, Y, Z is what? 1. So here what can we say? X is equal to, this shows that this triplet X is equal to R square minus S square, Y is equal to 2RS, and Z square equal to R square plus S square is a primitive Pythagorean triplet. So at last let's rewrite that part. Therefore this X, Y, Z is a Pythagorean triplet, primitive Pythagorean triplet, that is X is equal to R square minus S square, Y is equal to 2RS, and Z equal to R square plus S square is a primitive Pythagorean triplet. So this is about this theorem. So here we will stop for this video. In next video, we will see some examples on this. Okay, thank you.